question again. I should really do a video. Crochet diagrams, how do you make them? Great question.
Welcome to my channel, and I'm here to inspire you, give you crochet advice, and help you along with your next project.
So when I was a child, I bought this book. This is the exact book that I purchased, and in fact, my bus ticket from going to college and orientation is used as a bookmark inside this thing. That's how old this thing is. So I learned to crochet with this, and when you open this book, you'll notice that there's crochet diagrams. I won't hold it out to you for copyright reasons, but there's crochet diagrams for all the stitches and the patterns that are shown in here. So I originally thought when I learned to crochet, other than the double crochet and the chain that my mom showed me, I thought all patterns have crochet diagrams. I'm not a strong reader, I'll be honest with you. And so when I can follow the roadmap of a crochet diagram, it actually makes a lot more sense to me. And it wasn't until Red Heart asked me to do a pattern just as a testing trial to see if I could actually teach for them. And they gave me a pattern without a crochet diagram. I'm like, where's the diagram? And realizing I actually have to learn how to read a pattern. So the crochet diagrams that you see within books and stuff, if it's actually really professionally done, are using Adobe Illustrator. So here is one of my diagrams that I worked on, and this here is using Adobe Illustrator. So one thing that you'll find that there's other programs out there that promise to be able to make crochet diagrams. It gets really, really dicey once you start getting into really fun stuff. So for example, do you see how the stitches are leaning over like this? That is something that some of those programs cannot do, be able to align things properly and etc. So that's one of the things that you'll find really quickly to that you have limitation. The way I could best describe it is that learning this program has been a really steep climb. It's like climbing a mountain. But once you start understanding how the program works, it becomes a lot more easier. And one thing I guess I can recommend is that if you go onto YouTube, you can enter in different things. So start with your Adobe Illustrator and then say, how do you do this? And then how do you do that? And this is how Daniel and I actually learned how to make all these diagrams first. So we didn't learn how to actually do the diagrams, but we learned how to use the programming so that we could actually get started. And when I think about my very first patterns that we do have, is that I had to learn a lot of little key elements, and you can only really do that step by step. So this is the very first diagram I ever did in Adobe Illustrator. You can see things are not lining up properly. The spacing is off, but this is the best that I could do. So like, look at the chains, they don't really follow around, but that was literally at the time of learning. So you have to get yourself started at a certain point to be able to start getting comfortable in the shaping. At the time, I did not have a standard for how these shapes looked, I just guessed. And so in time, you end up coming up with the different concepts. Here that I'm about to do, you can see that I am learning how to do different things. So when I go and look here, you're going to notice is that, you know, you use a lot of different things in order to keep everything aligned like so. So these are the kind of elements that you may not find in other programs, but all of this stuff is manually created in Adobe Illustrator, and different things happen to be this way. So where would you go to learn something like this? The actual is quite simple, online, of course. So I showed you a bit of my computer programming. So a great resource to be able to learn how to do the basics of crochet diagram work is actually by Edie Ekman. I'll put a link in the more information of this video. Go to the video description, I'll put a link for her website. And she teaches literally how to make these diagrams from a very basic point of view, but I strongly recommend that you know how to use Adobe Illustrator, just the absolute basics, and have that program available for you. I just took her course. I've been crochet designing on the computer for quite some time, but her course allowed me to refine my skills to get myself to a better place, to be able to learn how to do this stuff much better. And that's the best place to start. I do not want to teach how to do stuff on a computer like this, because my patience level is really quite short when it comes to getting people to find the buttons and stuff. Edie does a great job. She does handouts before the class so that you know what she's going to be doing. And then even if you're lost in the class, her handouts match her course workshop. So as she's saying, well, click here, click here, click here, her worksheet also says that as well. So these crochet diagrams, a lot of people want a quick fix on being able to have a program to bang in a pattern and automatically do it. As far as I know, it does not exist. I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad news. But for myself, this this allows us to be more global in our approach, and it also gives people more of an understanding. So the way that I see these crochet diagrams is like a map. I know, the old map before GPS, to understand, because when I look at this, I can see my pattern actually in crochet format, and I just gotta stitch the work and do the colors. And it's actually really quite fun. So that is kind of where crochet diagrams originate, and you have to start somewhere. And the learning curve on Adobe is a bit tough. I'm not gonna lie about that. So it's a bit tough, and I think if you're really determined, I think anybody can accomplish anything. The programming does cost you money to have, so it's not free. So, you know, that's why a lot of pattern our designers charge for the patterns, because stuff like this is a monthly fee in order to have it. And so then they work it into the cost of actually doing the crochet designs and etc. So that's my story. Crochet diagrams at its best.